finally sits in my mother. The chemical enemy drip, she's at another one of her treatments. It's hard to witness, but how could I miss this? She's never needed anyone, always the strongest. And I remember well when I was young, what she did for me when I was sick. We didn't know what it was, but she saw this lump on the side of my neck. Got it checked, then checked into Children's Hospital with all them other kids too. She sat with me all day daily, said I refused to wear a gown. Sat on the covers, fully dressed, ready to bounce. And I notice she's much the same when she's at the weekly chemo. She's always saying how she looks forward to these days because she can attack her killer. Get back in the thing. I see you looking at that shit and telling it to get in the fucking ring. Then afterwards you treat yourself to a frozen yogurt. Matter of fact, that's probably the real reason you look forward to it. But she deserves it. All the froyo in the land. And even more than my hospital visit as a kid, I remember how she helped me with this problem I had. I was always sad and worried about things an 8-year-old shouldn't be concerned with. I thought it was unworthy, and any scary thing that occurred to me, I imagined being something I might find myself involved in. And I particularly recall the night I broke down. Terror crept up on me, my breath collapsed, it was a vacuum of sound. I was plagued, panicked with the thought of death. When everything in the world's over, what's left? Grandpa's gonna die soon, is he scared? What does he do all day? He lives alone, his children moved on. Is he ready to say goodbye? If it was my turn, would I? I said this all to my mom, and then together we cried. She said, David, you have too much time to live. Don't do this to yourself. There's peace in your young heart, and I can already tell it's gonna be tough for you, but there's a light inside you. Use it. Never lose it. It's a life, and you gotta choose it. And then she wiped away the tracks of the tears running down my face. And she gave me a four-color button fancy pen. I get it now, but I didn't get it then. She knew I'd write, and she was right. I'm writing now with a similar pen. So mama, I'ma tell you now what you told me way back then. It's gonna be tough for you, but you got a lot more living. But you know that, you competitive, and you're gonna win. And when you do, I'ma be here with you, like you were for me.